Let's go now to Emily Deem, who's live in Seymour this morning, checking out all the festivities for this special day. Hi, Emily.
Angela, good morning to you. Hi, everybody. We are inside the Seymour Community Museum, something that's new out here in Seymour and to Burgerfest. And hey, you can come check it out today if you're coming out to the festivities. And something else that's new, the face of Hamburger Charlie. We have John Stelz here with me this morning. Good morning to you, John.
Good morning.
Thank you so much for being with us. And, you know, we're saying you're the new face of Hamburger Charlie. This will be your first year at Burgerfest. How's it going for you?
It's going great. Last night I was at the balloon rally, and it was just tremendous. It's great to be able to meet people and get out and celebrate this Burger Fest here in our town. And I think it's also important to be able to give back to our community. I fried burgers for 6 years. The guys that were back at the grills last night were a little envious that I wasn't at the hot grills last night, but I was able to get out and meet some people. So it was a lot of fun.
So we are inside, you know, the Seymour Community Museum, something that's new out here and that they're celebrating in the community. Why don't you go ahead and tell us how Seymour became the home of the hamburger?
Seymour became the home of the hamburger in 1885 at the Outagamie County Fair right here, which is held right here in Seymour. Charlie Negrin, a young boy of 15 years old, was serving meatballs at the fair, and he'd served meatballs throughout the Fox Valley and through at other fairs as well. But in 1885, he all of a sudden realized that the people who wanted to eat the meatballs didn't want to sit and wait for them. They wanted to go see their agricultural exhibits, and they wanted to do other things at the fair. So Charlie knew just what to do, and at the young age of 15, being the entrepreneur that he was, he found some bread. And he took those meatballs and he smashed them down, I guess, and put them in between the two slices of bread. And there was the birth of the hamburger right here in good old Seymour. And people in other towns in Texas and New York and Connecticut, they claim that they are the home of the hamburger as well, but they do not provide the evidence going back to 1885.
And the history of the festival, I mean, you can see all of the buttons down there, the t-shirts. This Burger Fest is going to be really exciting to celebrate another year.
Burger Fest is going to be a great time once again. It's our 24th annual Burger Fest. It's get cheesy out here, and we're making grilling a 190-pound cheeseburger today, which will be served up at 3 o'clock. And your button, you buy a button to get in, it's $3 prior to the event. Of course, today if you come out, it'll be $5 at the gate. But the gate, the receipt, the button will get you in here to this museum as well. So if you want to come and cool off, this is a gem. It's a beautiful, beautiful building. It's a beautiful piece of history right here in Northeast Wisconsin. And it's a great time. We're going to have a great time today. It's going
to
be a lot of fun.
A lot to see and a lot to learn. Thank you so much for being with us this morning. We'll send it back to you.
All right. Thank you, Emily.